Hi, I'm Priya from Lakshmi, and today I'm going to talk about the most loved metal, the shiny investment we Indians love, gold. You can purchase it in physical forms like gold jewelry, coins, bullions, and in digital forms like sovereign gold bonds, gold ETFs, gold mutual funds, etc. We often tend to believe that gold jewelry is an investment, but instead, it's a luxury and hence cannot be categorized as an investment. Physical gold or gold jewelry comes with a huge markup. This is because of three reasons. Number one, upon buying physical gold, a 3% GST needs to be paid. Number two, making and design charges erode the value of gold. Number three, since gold is in physical form and needs to be protected from theft and damage, a small price needs to be paid for storage and insurances. These additional costs are impossible to recover while selling gold jewelry. Hence, considering gold jewelry as an investment is a big no. Some investors often mistake physical gold as an investment option too. They may think that gold coins and bullions don't fetch making and design charges, but one can't ignore the storage and protection cost as well as the GST that follows. Physical gold could be an alternative if you know for sure that you are going to convert it into a luxury, that is gold jewelry, at some point. In today's time, if you are a smart investor, you will realize the benefits of investing in gold digitally. It's hassle-free, fairly valued, and a pure form of investment. Here is how you can invest in gold the smart way. Sovereign gold bonds are issued by RBI on behalf of Government of India. It's like buying real gold but in certificate format. These bonds are issued in tranches and are regarded as the most lucrative way of investing in gold. Minimum investment is 1 gram and maximum is 4 kgs for individuals and Hindu undivided families and 20 kgs for trusts and similar entities. It can be purchased online as well as offline through banks, exchanges, registered brokers, etc. and you don't need a DMAT account. You can buy SGP through Lakshmi as well. So if you're looking for a cost-effective way to add gold in your portfolio, then SGP may be the option for you. If you want to invest for long term, get a fixed interest rate of 2.5% per annum on your investment amount. And if you hold the bond till maturity, the returns are tax exempted. That's awesome, right? Gold mutual funds are those funds that invest in gold directly or indirectly. They invest in shares of gold mining and distribution companies, physical gold, gold ETFs, etc. You can make a minimum investment of rupees 100, and the best part is there is no maximum investment limit. You can invest in gold mutual funds through asset management companies, registered brokers, and more. Or you can start your investments with Lakshmi with a click of a button by downloading our app. Do check it out. Gold mutual funds are suitable for investors who want to invest in small amounts and are looking for a liquid way of investing in gold. You can also make a regular investments by starting an SIP in these funds. What's great is that you get a benefit of professional fund management here who takes the decisions to generate returns on your investments. Gold ETFs are listed and traded on the National Stock Exchange and the Bombay Stock Exchange like any stock of a company. It can be bought and sold continuously at market prices, and gold ETFs invest in 99.5% pure gold. The minimum investment for gold ETF is 1 unit, which is equivalent to 1 gram of gold, and there is no maximum upper limit. Gold ETFs can be bought on BSE or NSE through any broker if you have an active DMAT and a trading account. These are ideal for investors who are looking for long-term or short-term investment options or trade options or are looking for an investment that offers easy liquidity. Investors can sell their ETF units directly on the stock exchange without any entry or exit load charges. Talking about digital gold plan, it's a cost-effective and a convenient way of accumulating the yellow metal. It enables you to buy, sell, and accumulate pure gold in fractions anytime, anywhere. You can invest in digital gold plan with as little as rupee 1 and a maximum of up to rupees 2 lakhs. You'll have to pay 3% GST on purchase, and in certain cases, the companies offer limited storage facilities. So, after 5 years, either you have to take the physical delivery or sell the gold. Digital gold plan can be bought online and is stored in insured vaults by the seller on behalf of the investor. All you require is an internet banking or a mobile banking facility, and you are set to invest in gold digitally anytime, anywhere. It is ideal for investors who want the dual benefits of investing in gold as well as the flexibility to convert it in physical form at some point in time. You can invest in small amounts, but you must remember one thing, that as of now, digital gold plans are not under the purview of any financial regulator. Therefore, one needs to select the platform very carefully while investing. The tax implication mostly remains same across instruments. If gold is held for less than 36 months, the tax is charged at slab rates, and if it is held for more than 36 months, a flat rate of 20% is charged, considering the inflation adjusted value of your investment along with the other charges. Gold is a safety net that you must incorporate in your portfolio. So invest in gold the smart way by either opting for gold mutual funds, gold ETFs, sovereign gold bonds, or digital gold plans. So that's it from me, guys. If you'd like to know more about gold instruments or you want me to cover any other financial instrument, do drop your suggestions in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next video. To get started on your investment journey, download the Lakshmi app. And to get more such informational content, subscribe to our channel. Thank you.